You got to tell us, man, what is a snow globe shaker? I mean, I guess you're just shaking snow globes, man. It's just a creative
Well,
thing.
it is. It's funny. I actually just I moved to Florida. I'm in Tampa now, about a year ago. So I been going through the process of getting new plates and license and everything. And I just got a custom plate. It says Snow Globe on it. So what happened, Brian, is about 3 years ago, I was on a stage speaking, and this idea popped in my head. And I've learned that when ideas pop in, share them. And it was about snow globes, but I don't even think I owned a snow globe at the time. I now have probably about 80 because I buy a snow globe everywhere I visit that's a new place. But what struck me was that about snow globes are beautiful, right? They're all beautiful. You've never seen really an ugly snow globe except those ones that are not round and they make squares and things. But they're all intended to be beautiful, but the magic of a snow globe is shaking it. That's why snow globes exist. They exist to be shaken, but most snow globes are never shaken because they're good enough as they are. And so the metaphor around leadership and life is that, number one, we have to be willing to shake things up, starting with ourselves. We need to encourage our team members to shake themselves up. We don't shake their snow globes, which is what leaders too often do, which creates chaos and stress. We encourage and empower and support them in shaking their own. But the key is when we shake things up, we also have to actually shift and change things. Because otherwise, you shake the snow globe, and as soon as you stop, and this is what I love about it, I go to an audience and say, what happens when you stop shaking? And they all yell, well, it starts to settle.